I had Dr. Bilal Phillips recently here on the broadcast with me, and I cited that incident when Umar, radiallahu anhu, was in Sham, and he wanted to take a decision whether to go to Amwas or not, and you know he consulted with the Muhajirin, basically asking for a reference from the Sunnah or what a Muslim should do. And then he consulted with Al-Ansar, and both groups basically said, we have nothing to offer you. And in the morning, Omar reached his own conclusion and saying, okay, I'm heading to back to Medina. And one of the people said, are you fleeing from Qadarullah? And he made that beautiful statement, from Qadarullah to Qadarillah. But really, I'm citing all of this just to decide to go into Amwas or not. Umar is looking for a body of jurists to make a decision. And these days, we have this unprecedented, COVID-19. And we have fatwas right and left and right. One of the most amazing things that I'm hearing now that people are saying, we shouldn't be fasting because there is danger on our health, because according to the doctors, the COVID-19 requires, nutrition and how can you address the broader issue, the three lamps to just give fatwa that you can lead salah in the masjid and people can follow you at home? And I mean, what is your take
First of all, La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. I think that this pandemic has exposed a major shortcoming, in our midst, and I think we're going to have to make some corrective measures. Beginning to take corrective measures. It to me, it's not so much the freelance fatwa. It's the quality of the fatwa themselves. Because what you see is that many of them in the same fatwa, there's a contradiction between the premises and the conclusions, the evidences and the conclusions that they are coming to based on those evidences. It's unbelievable sometimes. And I'm saying, how is it that, our level of scholarship I'm not even going to say that it's dipped so low, but I think Sheikh Karim, I think we're dealing with a broader problem. And that is that with social media, anybody can have a platform. And so what happens is, this person who came out of the woodwork, nobody knows them before, or certain people who are known for certain things. But he has a doctor in front of his name. He's actually a doctor of gynecology, for example, but he's giving fatwa in the Sharia. Which is ajeeb jiddan yani. Ar-rajul yandur tul al-yawm fi furuj al-nisa ba'dayn yatla.
We're not going to translate that.
Yufti lana. Yani say gharib wallahi. Say gharib. Anyway, I'm not translating that.
Okay.
Whoever didn't understand it. But I think that it's, I think that we're going to have to, as an ummah, we're going to have to take account of ourselves and recognize that not just because somebody's popular, it does not give them the right to, speak about the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, especially for mustajiddat, yani things that are new occurrences that need some real strong fiqh.
No.
And like you said, it would be better that it doesn't come from individuals, which is why, alhamdulillah, yani the fiqh councils that have been formed, within the last 50 years or so. These are very important for the ummah. And I wish that they had the ability to address some of these issues a bit more quickly. you know, so that it would shut down some of the yani unsaf talabat al ilm, yani those people who are not even really, you know, strong students of knowledge, but they put themselves out there because there's a void that needs to be filled. So, I mean, this again is a bigger issue. I think, you know, some of us are going to have to take responsibility for, you know, addressing these issues more quickly. But again, what I like about the fiqh bodies, and I'm just going to say this quickly, inshallah, and then, you know, we can get back to the question, is that, alhamdulillah, these scholars are not too proud to take from the people who are professionals in their field. So if it's a medical issue, they're going to sit down with doctors are going to be a part of that committee, you know, as they're building their fatwa. If it's something that deals with new issues related to buying and selling, they will definitely have business people there. They have real estate people there when it comes to, you know, things dealing with contracts. So these fiqh bodies tend to bring together the best scholars in their field. And then when it comes to specific issues, they are well informed about those issues and are able to make, you know, they're able to make fatawa that are relevant and correct, alhamdulillah. So I actually made myself forget your original question because I went off on a tangent. So what was the question?
Well, the question here is the what is your take on people who say you should not fast Ramadan this year?
Right. So alhamdulillah, I mean there are many Muslim physicians actually who have come together to tackle this issue, and I'm not aware of any evidence from a medical perspective that shows that there's any substantial harm.
They actually base it on the fear of.
Yeah, but what I'm saying is even the Muslim physicians that have talked about this subject, they say that fasting does not do anything to make one more likely to contract the COVID-19. That there's no evidence that shows that fasting would make one more likely to contract. And so therefore, in the absence of that evidence, then we go with the default position, which is that we have to fast, and we can't take this fast lightly. This is min mabani al-Islam. It's from the foundations of the deen, what the scholars later called arkan al-Islam, right? The pillars of Islam. Even though the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam didn't use that terminology. He said, buni al-Islam wa ala khams. Yani Islam is built on these things. So this is a foundation of our deen. We can't just leave off a foundation of the deen because of the fear of something that is khawfun wahmiyun aslan. Yani it's an imagined fear. It's not even something that is substantiated. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. That's what I know from the physicians. And if there's medical evidence to prove otherwise, then I'm open to hearing that medical evidence.